Well, there's a right way and a wrong way to do it. Etiquette expert Micah Lewis is here to show us all about what we need to do. Yes, how to do it.
Yeah.
First of all, I didn't even know there was an etiquette. I thought it was just...
Just do what you want to do. You think that's what we need to do, Rashi?
Oh, no, I'm not saying that's what we need to do.
Okay.
So what do we do?
Now, what we do first is the host actually do the toast.
Oh, okay.
So the first toast, you know, normally we're so excited and we want to do the toast.
Uh-huh.
If you're not the host, you have not financed it, or you did not plan it, you should not be doing the first toast. So that means that allow them to have their shine, okay?
Yes.
Tip number two, you want to make sure that you do not... force someone to drink.
Right.
Okay. For example, one thing I think about is that when you are a great host, you need to make sure you are able to accommodate everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning that everyone is not able to drink.
Mm-hmm.
It could be medical reasons, they may be on recovery, or they may be pregnant and they don't want you to know.
Right.
So a good way to ask, what would you like to have to drink?
Right.
So you can use ginger ale. You can use Sprite. You can use anything that's bubbly. But also remember, you want to make sure everyone feels comfortable. So have something both for non-drinkers and for drinkers.
Okay. And then what about this whole thing when it comes to a long toast? Like, how long should your toast
be? Okay, so your toast should not be a story.
Right, yes.
It should be no more than 10 to 15 seconds.
Yes.
Happy New Year. Thank you for gathering. We wish you a prosperous New Year.
Yes.
That is the time that you just welcome everyone.
Mm-hmm.
And typically, what another rule of thumb is, when we make a toast, we always say we have to clink the glass.
Mm-hmm.
That's a no-no.
Oh, for real?
No. You're actually supposed to step in the center of the room.
Oh.
And then you just hold your glass up, and you just wait for everyone to come around. And if it's a huge party, you already delegate some of your friends or family members to kind of bring them in.
Okay.
But you don't have to say anything. This is crystal.
You just get in the middle. Yes,
right.
You do that. Okay. And then avoid tapping your glass with silverware, right?
Yes.
So that's like, you don't do that.
Yeah. No, because also this is crystal, so you don't want to break the glass.
Right, right.
So you just step out in the middle. Hold it up. Eye level.
Uh-huh.
And you're good to go.
All right. Perfect. And I have to say, so when people make these speeches, they usually think like everyone, you know, think like individually people.
No, but we don't have time for that.
Yeah. So you're saying, because, you know, you'd be rolling your eyes like, I don't know who this person is. I don't know who this person is. And we only like
this. Right. 10 to 15 seconds.
Really, people.
If you're over a minute, you are way too long.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
And then also, what I want to talk about is make sure that when you're toasting, you're not clinking the glass.
Okay.
That is what we typically do. You do not clink. You just actually hold it up, make eye contact with the person around you. No, you're not doing a Pledge of Allegiance. Can you bring it down, please? Thank you. Bring it midway, eye level between the ear and shoulder.
Well, I'm hosting.
And you're there.
I'm hosting, so let me talk. All right? I would like to thank you for being here.
Oh, my goodness.
And I would also like to thank Stephen Morgan for providing us with a forecast that isn't going to be that bad for New Year's Eve.
Come on, Stephen. Yes, let's hear it.
That was about 10.